know, I really believe that not every person is meant to be a mom. And their mother has lost all of her children. She's lost all of her kids. And these last three that I'm now raising, she was partying and all this stuff after my brother died, because she has a history of doing drugs, right? And she was just out doing her thing, you know, partying and stuff like that. She got a new dude and she was hanging out with the guy's kids and, you know, well, abandoning her own kids, like dumb. And CPS came and they basically said, you know, if somebody doesn't take these kids, they're going to go into a foster home. So she came over to the house and she signed a paper, and she was perfectly sober when she signed the paper. She did not want to have anything to do with the kids. She abandoned them.
The video is shocking and heartbreaking. We're told this is Patricia Ripley walking with her 9-year-old son Alejandro on the bank of a canal in West Kendall. She's stroking his hair, looking around, and in a single move, shoving him into the water. He says Ripley returns with a bystander, and with another man, they pull Alejandro from the water. Here you can see they dry him off. Neighbors say mom and son then leave.
Kind of stripped him down, dried him off, and she just walked that way. The older couple went into the first hallway.
Police say this was Ripley's first attempt to kill her son, who was autistic and could not speak. About an hour later, they say she led him to another body of water at the Miccosukee Golf and Country Club. His lifeless body would be found the next day.
All right,
yes, sir.
Don't sit here and lie to me anymore. The lie stops now. Do you understand? Do you understand me?
What are you talking about?
What happened to Alejandro?
What happened?
You killed your son. That's what you did.
No, 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 you can't say that.
Don't touch me. Yes,
I'm
I can't say that.
No, I don't know.
Yes, yes.
No.
Yes.
They said, no.
Yes. You better come and tell us the truth.
No,
yes. Okay.
No, I don't care. No, what are you talking about?
Yes, you did. You're going to have to tell the truth.
You are not the father. Miss Miller.
You're respectful.
I'm sorry.
Miss Miller.
I'm sorry.
That's a lot of nerve considering the alternative is somebody that don't want nothing to do with you or your child. That's a lot of nerve. You just showed me where your priorities were right there. Because I held out hope that you weren't just acting a fool because you so mad at him because he cheated on you, that you would cheat your child out of a father. But that cheering you did, what you cheering? I'm a single mother with nobody that loves me or my child. What you cheering for?
I'm not.
No, you were. He is over here breaking down because he loves this child so much. Sitting here day after day after day with women hoping a man would drive 16 miles to see their baby, much less 160 miles each way, and abide by a court order and sign a birth certificate and come day after day and week after week so they can grow visitation to have a relationship with a child. And you have no compassion for not just him, but for Zaylee. She's 3 years old. Now, he's not just gonna be heartbroken. We gotta break this news to her. And y'all over here cheering like it's a sport. This is this baby's life. And I asked you, where's this other man? I don't know. And you know he don't want nothing to do with you. Sitting up there cheering.
If I was to say that he doesn't call his kids to check on them, ever. He doesn't even pick them up himself when they do visit. And sends somebody else every single time. He doesn't believe that a day and a half to 2 days is worth driving 45 minutes to get their kids for Christmas. Refuses to pay court-ordered child support or get a job. And talks bad about me, or mom, to my kids. And refuses to be involved in any decisions or anything that has to do with the kids. And sometimes just doesn't show up at all. What's the first thing that comes to your head? Deadbeat dad? Now, what would you say if I said it was she? The mom. There's a stigma that moms can't be deadbeats. And to be honest, that is my situation. My stepchildren's mother refuses to be any kind of part in my kids' lives. Except for when they go there for court-ordered visitation, where she's too busy with her other child and other extracurricular activities I'm not going to mention. But the rest of what I said when I said he is what she's doing. So are you ready to accept deadbeat moms now? Because let me tell you, having two special needs children, six people to support, and trying to just survive when the other parent gets to do absolutely zero or acknowledge their children's feelings is not okay. And any mom or any woman that wants to defend it is wrong, and probably a deadbeat mom themselves. I said what I said.
My father, nowhere to be found. You know why he was nowhere to be found? Because I just got a relationship with him a few months ago. Because my mom told me my dad wasn't to keep me away from my dad. I'm 26, bro. My mom kept me away from my dad for 26 years. You know what kept me away from him? My mom told me that my dad said I was a mistake and kept me away from my father. Every time, this has been looking for me since I was a kid.
Yeah.
He's been looking for me. Can you imagine all the kids out there who got a fast mom telling them their daddy ain't but the daddy looking for him? I finally talked to my dad. He's a good dude. My mom told me my dad has not paid child support since I was a kid. I finally meet this. He has an envelope full of shit proof showing he's been paying child support. He told me, he said, your mom is a lying, manipulative. I have not talked to my mom in months. You know why? My mom called me. My mom's in California. My dad's in North Carolina. I moved out of L.A. I can't live in North Carolina or L.A. because I hate those places because of the trauma I went through on both of those places. My mom calls me. What you doing, baby? What's going on? I'm at my dad's house. What the f*** you doing at the house? Didn't I say don't discuss family business? Like, my dad comes and he busts through the door. My dad is happy and married. He's a street. Can't talk about what he do, but he's a street. He's happy and married. My mom has been bitter and having sex with so many goddamn dudes of different races, and she just got married recently. That she met on Tinder for 1 month. My mom didn't get married because she was in love. She got married because she didn't want to be lonely.
Yeah.
My dad bust through the door and snatched the phone. I was trying to, like, no. Like, hello? Put my son back on the phone. No, it's my son too. What do you want? Put my son back on the phone. And my dad loses it. Going in on my mom. And I'm listening to my mom. All that slapping, abuse, and beating up, beating me up, choking me when I'm on the floor, beating me with belts, wrapping hangers around other hangers, beating me till I pass out, then wake back up, welts on my back, scars. My mom turned into a 2-year-old little girl when my dad started talking to her. She talked to me like a my entire life. He's yelling on the phone, you mad because I left you. And I didn't want to be with you no more. And you kept my son away from me as a weapon. My mom used her kids as a weapon. She used me and my little sister as a weapon. Whenever my mom would get pissed off by my dad or my sister's dad, she would say, "We'll never see your son again if you disrespect my son."
There you are, Amy. I've been looking for you. My dad just kicked your mom out. Told her, do not come back. That he was done with her.
Good. I don't want to see her anyways. I hate her. The fact that she's lied to me all these years, making me think that my dad never wanted me, when this whole entire time, he's been searching for me. He's wanted me. He's loved me. And because of her and her selfish reasons, I've missed out on 18 years of knowing him. I don't blame you. I'd hate her too. I hate her for you. I hate her for making you feel this way and putting you through this. I love you so much. You're my sister. And when you hurt, I hurt. I couldn't imagine how you're feeling right now. It is what it is. What's done is done. The hurt is here. And honestly, I don't know how to get past this. The really sad part, Jenna, is the fact that my mom, I always knew that she likes to manipulate people to get what she wants. But I guess I was somewhat okay with it because she always told me that she was doing it for us. And I never thought that she would use it against me like she has. She would see me crying at night, wishing and wanting for my dad. I always thought that I was a loser. I mean, what kid is worth something if their own dad doesn't even want them, you know? I'm so sorry, Amy. Honestly, I can't imagine how it feels for you to know this whole entire time, one, that your dad has wanted you and has been searching for you, and then to find out that your mom's been lying and hiding it from you, it's just terrible. You know I lost my mom to cancer. Even though it was hard, I got to know her, love her, and be loved by her. And so the fact that your mom deprived you of knowing your father, I see why you hate her and why it's unforgivable. Yeah. What a great way to spend my 18th birthday. Woohoo! I know it's hard, but we can't let her win. You are amazing and loved. So let's just go out tonight for your birthday. Me, you, my dad, your dad, and all our friends.